planet Earth, welcome back to the Bad Dates Podcast. The Bad Dates troupe is composed of five single people who go on dates with men and women weekly, report the events in a message group, and the story with the most votes is read in the episode. Today's episode is The Cenophile.
Love is like oxygen. You get so much, you get too high. Not enough and you're gonna die. Love gets you high.
I matched with a 33-year-old actor I'd never heard of, and that led me to two thoughts. I'm either going to meet the new Steve Carell, or one of those boring guys who think they're interesting because they make their annoying friends laugh. He suggested a romantic French comedy film. While I like comedy, I don't have a lot of patience for European films. So a French comedy is like trying to eat a hot dog in a croissant. Sounds like it could be a good mix, right? About 10 minutes later, I kissed his neck and he asked, "What was that?" And I said, "My hand is unemployed and looking for a job." He pushed my hand aside, so I got up.
My hand's unemployed, looking for a job.
Getting that with my Netflix subscription. He followed me out of the theater and apologized and asked if we could go back and finish watching the movie. Cenophiles, here's the tip. If you want to see a movie, don't take a date to the theater. And if you want to have sex, good luck. Next week is episode 100, and women are already vying for the best bad
date.
Porra. I'm almost shitting myself here.
Oh, I'm sorry, Uncle Rob, but somebody has to stop you.
Of what? To listen podcasts?
Oh, you know that is not what I meant.
He called Bad Dates. In this episode, the girl went to a French movie with an actor.
Yeah, it's a famous podcast.
It is?
Yeah, and you know, maybe you should try going on a date sometime too.
I'd rather just listen bad stories and laugh than experience it myself.
Oh, come on, what is the big deal? Just download the app just to try it.
Don't even start this conversation. Sky, bring me the check, please.
She was wearing a tiger costume when you walked in on them. How are you handling all of this?
Good. Very good.
It's okay, Robert. The life snake.
Excuse me?
You wrote this in your column months ago. It's funny. It's like, if you do something wrong in life, then and bad things will happen to you, right?
Yeah, you're right.
I love when you put those Brazilian expressions in your writing. But your last five columns have gone from wine to water. I mean, and worse, from red wine to this broccoli mango juice.
It's any problem with it?
Why does healthy food always taste like hell?
With my writing.
People are used to reading funny pieces like 10 Tips for Tolerating Your Mother-in-Law, The Art of Blaming the Dog, oh, my favorite, Jumping the Fence, The Brazilian Way of Cheating. I mean, and now you're writing Men Cry Too. How many tears can this pillow handle? And most recently, Cure Your Depression with Avocados.
They can cure it.
Beans, too? Why can't you write something like, say, Cure Your Depression with the Joy of Farting? See? That's more interesting than your guacamole essay. I mean, write whatever you want, but funny.
But I don't know what is funny anymore these days.
Well, do whatever research you need to get back to where you were. And stop acting like a teenage YouTuber. The newspaper owner wants me to fire you and hire his daughter because she started some opinion blog.
Is it any good?
She's 14, Robert. She thinks she's Greta Thunberg. I mean, the biggest climate change she's seen is when the air conditioning stops working. Can you write better than a 14-year-old or not?
I will try.
So, I'll just install the app for you and just try it out. I mean, what's the worst that could happen?
This is not a good idea.
Oh, okay, but it is a good idea to have a picture of your ex-wife next to your bed while she's having fun in Greece.
She's a very important part of my life. Why should I hate her?
You don't have to hate her. Okay, so how old are you, 40?
Do I look 40?
39?
35.
Okay, tell me three things you like.
Root beer, mac and cheese.
To do? What do you like to do?
You didn't say me. Riding, golfing, and farting.
Okay, so I'm gonna put that you like to drink beer and play board games, old man.
Okay, works.
All right, now how old should your woman be?
I don't know. What is the range?
Well, the range is 60 plus. You want to put 60 plus?
No.
Okay, well, the minimum is 18, and you are not rich enough to be a sugar daddy, so I'm gonna put, how about 30?
I don't want to do this.
All right, then 27.
It's 10 years younger than me.
Aren't you 35? Look, you know that Brazilian guy, Jesus Light?
Mm.
He was 30 years younger than Madonna. You know, you Brazilian guys like these age differences.
Oh, we Brazilian, all of us?
Okay, no, not your type. Whoa, too smiley. Oh no, hell no, she's way out of your league.
My league? Do I have a league? Bring her back, let me see her.
Oh no, once they're gone, they're gone.
You know, like your wife.
Yeah, oh, she's cute, but she looks way too much like me. Oh no, she's way too good for you.
What does this blue star do?
No!
What?
Damn.
Mm.
That's the one you press when you want to let someone know you like them a lot.
Just unsend it.
No, you can't. She's already been notified. Well, if she likes you too, then... Oh, hey, look. She likes you back.
Hey, if you don't like it, just delete the account.
What if I just delete it now, then?
Come on, Uncle Rob. Seriously?
Yeah.
Uncle Rob, come on.
Oh.
Oh, don't be like that. We just live.
No, no, forget it. Mmm, smelling good. What are you doing?
Carrot cake.
Oh.
Hello. What's up?
Uncle Rob got a match on Tinder. He won't even talk to her.
What? Go for it. Dave and I met on Tinder.
I thought you met on Cubs game when you were drunk.
That was after. First we matched on Tinder, started talking but never set a date. And then I got drunk at the Cubs game, showed up on the big screen and he recognized me.
Oh, how romantic.
Isn't it?
Boha! Rob got a Tinder date? How?
Oh, by mistake.
Oh, well that checks out. Let me see.
No.
Actually, Charlie has a good Tinder story too.
Brenda, there you go.
Come on, we have to tell Rob the good and the bad to manage his expectations.
Come, tell me everything.
No, it was one date, it was really bad.
See? Can you see that? Have you seen that? You see that? You see that?
I got catfished, man. What do you want me to tell you?
Huh? She was underage?
No. Overage. Like, way over.
Ooh. Too old to play video game with you?
Look, man. She tried to get me drunk and make me sing Kiss from a Rose in my underwear.
Did you do that?
No. I just forgot the lyrics. Hey, anyway, let's look at that phone, huh?
Oh.
Yeah, she's just a normal lady. It's not...
Oh. All right, I have an idea. How about we each take turns writing a message for Rob, and then when it's his turn, he can take over.
What about we delete the app and save me for the embarrassment?
Relax, Rob, we're having fun.
We who?
Look, I will show you the messages before I send them, okay? Chill.
Let me know when it's my turn. I'm going to be killing teenagers in here, so.
Yep. All right, guys. What are you doing?
What happened with how are you?
It's 2020. It's not the 1950s anymore, okay?
Okay, yeah. The Chivalry died in the 50s, right?
Yeah, I guess. Brenda, your turn.
Say, just got back from work. What do you do for a living?
I don't want to know.
How old is she?
She's 27. She's at tender 27, though, you know?
Yeah, so early 30s.
Okay, Charlie, it's on you.
How about, I don't know, what are you doing today?
Why I want to know it?
Okay, want to go for drinks?
Nope.
Uncle Rob, come on, this is how it works.
Calm down, she said yes.
It doesn't matter.
Just say yes.
Come on, say yes.
Are you gonna say yes?
No.
Sure, where?
Hey, no, give my phone back. Stop it, stop it.
Hey, she wants to come here.
Julie, stop it, I don't want to.
Fine with me.
Fine with me.
No, give my phone back, Julie.
9 p.m. good for you?
No, of course not. Today? No. Stop it. Give my phone back, Julie.
She'll be here at 9.
What? You gave her our address?
Yeah.
You don't know this woman. Why are you doing this?
Come on. And I deleted the app.
And I gave her my number as if it were yours, so when she messages me, we can just head out.
Great idea. Let's do this. You stay here, drink with her, I will leave it.
Oh, come on. How about we both get food and drinks for your date? It'd be great for you.
Dave cooked for me on our first official date.
I thought you guys just had sex in the car.
That was after. First, he drove me to his place and made dinner. It was incredible.
The food?
No.
First of all, I don't even like tacos.
Hey, what's up, Mr. Phil?
Hey, Julie. Hi, Robert.
Phil, you need to help me. Put the puffy corns back!
The beer, too.
You're not my father.
Yeah, not anymore.
Good idea.
Phil, please help me. She wants me to go on a date with this woman that I never saw in my life. Can you tell her that is a bad idea?
This guy, oh my God, he's putting toast and eggs in this thing. I need to get one.
For real? I don't know this woman. He's a stranger in my house.
Robert, I've been in my fourth marriage, and I've learned something new in every one of them. You should give the girl a shot. Want to know what I learned in the last one?
What?
Air fryers. My wife sent me this video and told me about this guy, Broggy. And he cooks everything in these things. I think I want one. Do you know?
Broggy? Is that a person?
Robert, my father used to say, every person is a planet. Maybe we should explore Uranus.
What?
Yes. See, come on. Let's launch this rocket.
Keep the change.
Here, you'll need that.
Ooh, thanks.
Oh. Your mother dumped me. No more family credit. Got it?
Could you be my father tonight?
If you get this fryer, I'll be your pappy.
Thanks, Dad.
Oh, another video. Ribs.
Theo, first 3 rounds on me.
Thanks.
The food's simmering. Don't forget to turn off the stove.
Okay. My head is exploding.
Oh, no. Maybe it's overheating because it's trying to remember how to date after 20 years.
Look, even your hair is leaving you.
Uncle Rob, listen to me. Fernanda's new boyfriend, he's gorgeous, he's rich, and he's hot.
So what?
So, you're none of these. That's why she won't come back anymore.
You have a weird way to explain things, right?
Look, instead of moping around here, you need to get up and get yours. I mean, who knows if tonight goes well, you start dating again, you forget all about Fernanda. Fechado?
Fechado.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Just one's good?
Take two, you're a big man, Rob.
All right, big man. Look, just be funny, be yourself, you're a funny guy. All right, you can brag about it tomorrow on your Instagram. It's gonna be great.
My boss told me to research funny things.
See, there you go. Put in some work and then write about it. All right, it's okay. Stay calm. Hey, you're a funny guy.
Funny guy.
All right.
Rob, what? In my room, I've got condoms and I got those little pills to make you feel more Brazilian, okay?
Do you think that I need pills to feel more Brazilian?
Yes.
Rob, I made you a playlist. Just command the Alexa to play it, okay?
Well, I don't think that I need it.
Alexa, sex lights.
Whoa.
I thought you only had these set up in your room.
Oh, that was after, once I realized that no one stays home during the day.
What is that?
Alexa, white lights?
It's her. Bye. All right, chop, everybody. Love Rob, be cool. You got this.
Thank you. Whew.
Who's there?
Hey, man, it's Lexa.
Okay. Did it open?
No.
Now?
Don't know.
And now?
No, can you try one more time?
Yeah, it's heavy and old. Push harder. Now?
Yeah, it's open.
Okay.
All right, see you in a minute.
See you. What?
Can you buzz the door again?
Now open?
One more time, please.
Open?
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Good posture.
You cannot handle her.
No, you can't.
Julie, I'm not prepared for this.
Rob? Rob?
That would be a good idea, sorry.
It was. It was the first time I ever punched anyone without saying hello first.
Oh, so we have a first.
Woohoo!
Are you sure you don't want to put ice on it?
No, I don't think it's broken. I guess it's just bleeding. Thanks.
Your call. Did you make food?
Tacos. You like it?
I'm okay.
Okay, there's wine too if you want.
Wine too? You have food and wine and a hot accent? What are you trying to do? Make me fall in love with you?
No, I just knew that the chivalry didn't die in 50s.
Yeah.
I'll get the wine for you.
Yeah, you stay here, I'll get it.
Okay.
It's weird. I feel like I've been here before. Have you always lived here?
No, my niece lives here. I moved it 4 months ago.
Hey, is everything all right up there?
Yeah, she's not 27. She's clearly 30-something.
Hey, bad daters. I'm the perfect candidate for episode 100. I even punched him in the face already. Unplanned. What's the challenge for today? Where's the wine?
I guess in the fridge.
We heard a scream. What happened?
Yeah, I heard it too. Wasn't here.
Oh, this is a good one.
Yeah, I heard this.
Do you have a corkscrew?
I guess in the top drawer. Forgot to check.
Okay, have fun.
Thanks.
I can find a corkscrew. Hey, do you have wine glasses?
Yes. Here, I'll get for you. It's right.
Hi.
Hi. Oh, yeah.
Say cheese.
Cheese. Cheese.
There you go. Oh, now you're unforgettable.
Oh, nice.
Okay, we can take that out now.
Oh, yeah.
So do you know why we have to look in each other's eyes when we toast?
My wife.
Wife?
My ex-wife used to say that if you don't do it, you jinx your sex life.
That's right. And did it?
Not for me.
Well, if that is why you split up, I should probably get going.
Oh, no. Wasn't because of it. Was... Well, she met this National Geographic photographer on Instagram. They start to talk. She sent some pictures for him. He sent some pictures to her. And you know, these guys know how to take a good picture of everything, right? So they fall in love and they are traveling the world together.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Did you hear that?
What?
I just ovulated.
Yeah, that's what National Geographic photographer does. Today they are in Greece, sailing a catamaran. Yeah, I guess that's a normal day in the life of a National Geographic photographer. Sailing a catamaran, camping in the desert, riding a tiger.
No, no one rides a tiger.
You're right, no one. Just National Geographic photographers. And they take pictures of it and show off everyone that don't believe in that.
Yeah, I'm jealous.
Of my wife? Who isn't?
Of the tiger. Can you imagine a National Geographic photographer mounting you?
Oh, I saw it happening. Oh. Yeah, my wife was a tiger.
Oh.
Is that count?
Okay, so how about this? You introduce me. I'll steal the photographer, your wife will be single again, win her back, and I'll get to travel the world with the photographer.
Deal. Works for me. Let's do it.
No, but seriously, so how long's it been since you guys split?
4 months and 3 days.
And you're already dating again? You dirty dog.
Yeah, no, I never used this Tinder before. My niece put it on my cell phone and yeah, she suggests Grindr, but I don't know what is it.
You should check it out.
Yeah?
Well, so how many dates have you been on?
So far, this is the second.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, tell me about the first date.
The first one was great. I met her at a salsa dance class, and we spent the last 20 years together.
Well, salsa is better than Tinder.
It is, because even when you swipe left, you're doing right. Right?
So one date and you guys spent 20 years together? Are you really this charming?
I don't think I am. But if we spend the next 20 years together, I'll be old enough for you to change my diapers.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Should we listen to some music?
Yes. So, Alexa, what do you want to listen to?
Here's something I found on the web. According to Amoeba.com, then there's the Ramones song, I Don't Want to Grow Up From There.
Wow, you have that too?
Oh, sorry. Wasn't a good idea.
It's okay. It's my family's curse. My grandma was named Lucy. Always asked if she was in the sky with diamonds. My aunt was named Roxanne. Always asked if those days were over. At least my mom, Layla, taught me how to put men on their knees.
Oh, good. Okay, works.
Yeah. She named me Alexa because she didn't think it would go with anything.
Yeah, she was wrong.
Yeah. Alexa, tell a joke funnier than that.
Why did the lemmings jump from the dock?
Terrible.
Too much peer pressure.
Terrible joke.
Terrible. I never had this. It's not mine. It's the friend of my niece.
Oh, really? They're super fun. Ask it something.
Alexa, what I have for lunch today?
Okay, for lunch, I recommend awesome grilled cheese sandwiches from All Recipes. 25 minutes to make. Serves 9.
Wasn't that
recipe? Send it to your phone.
Or
here next recipe.
No, I didn't.
That's like a really good suggestion, though. Grilled cheese is awesome.
Yeah, it is, but I didn't let you that.
No, it's not gonna guess things. So, you can give it to commands like Alexa, do Pikachu. Okay, stop, Alexa.
It's funny. Pikachu.
Alexa, stop.
It has been stopped.
Okay, try. Just ask it.
Let me see. Alexa, how do I hide a body?
If the death is expected, call the police non-emergency number and a funeral home of your choice. For an unexpected death, call 911.
Are you expecting a death?
No.
I'm gonna call
911. No. Sorry. Alexa, stop. Ooh, good timing. The owner of the thing sent a playlist. Alexa, play Brenda's playlist.
I don't see the playlist, Brenda's playlist.
You have to say the name of the playlist.
Oh. It's, wait.
Alexa. Play Wild Sex.
Here's a station for you based on the song Wild Sex.
These one words, right?
Good enough. Wow.
Huh? Like it?
Hey Alexa, sex legs.
We get it almost every night. Everybody here is out of sight. They don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose, they keep things light. Everybody was dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody feeling warm and right. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody's dancing in the moonlight.
Oh, we like.
Just let's slow down. Let's, we're going too fast.
I have to use the bathroom.
Yes, the hallway, down the hallway left. You're hot and Alexa, white light. Thank you. You suck. Ooh.
I think for the 100th episode, the challenge should be a little bit harder.
True, true. This one gotta be the best episode.
While you guys figure out a better challenge, I'm gonna try to have sex.
Alexa, candle light.
Sorry, I don't know that.
I'll try again. Candle lights. Candlelight. Candlelight.
Hey guys, starting our date now. No punch in the face, but met a guy leaving a funeral. Episode 100 is so mine.
Alexa, candle lights.
Your last Amazon order cannot be canceled. For details, go to your orders on Amazon.
I'm leaving now.
Ready?
Yeah, my friend at the bar nearby is feeling sick. I have to take her home.
Oh, the bar next here? My friends are there. I can call them.
No need. I really wanted to stay, but I should help her.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sorry, this divorce thing is messing with my head a lot, and this is my first date after 20 years of marriage, so I'm a little nervous. My ex-wife was my first and my only everything, so if we could see it and eat before I try something else would be great. But if you want to go to help your friend...
No, it's okay. Another friend's gonna help out. Wow, it smells really good.
Do you want some soda?
Oh, no, thanks. Oh, do you want wine?
I will check.
Hey, what if we do our top three episodes together for number 100? I know the guy crying episode was one of them, but what were the other two?
No wine, but chimichanga and ice cream. Want some?
No, that's okay. So how many people did you say live here?
Four. There's Brenda, who study gastronomy at Social Table. Charlie? Yeah, he plays video game all day and make a lot of money killing people virtually, I hope. And my niece Julie, she studies at Second City. You know, there's a lot of famous people from Second City. Well, there's 30 famous people and 30,000 that are not famous. I don't know which group she belongs to.
Groups are fun.
Are you good? Are you?
So tell me, I know this is maybe kind of strange, but how'd you and your wife meet?
Well, we met at a BDSM party.
No, you didn't.
No, we didn't. I'm from São Paulo, and she moved from Rio to study interior design. I was studying journalism at the time, but I was shy, so my mother sent me to salsa classes.
Salsa? Why salsa?
I don't know. She just sent me, and I just went. And Fernanda was in my class, so I asked her out because she didn't know anyone in São Paulo at the time. She said yes, we start to date. A couple of years after, I proposed her. She said yes again. And last year, she told me about this dream to move to the North of Americas. And then I said yes. But I didn't know at that time that she was talking with this National Geographic photographer. It's hard to compete, right? Because they know how to take photos, and good photos. And I just moved here, but that's life.
You seem like such a nice guy all the time. Nothing ever bothers you.
Used to be nothing, but whether I was cheated.
Oh, you know, it's probably just the hot peppers and the tacos. Have some water.
Thank you.
So tell me more about your wife.
Oh, she's bored, intelligent, that be. Bored, intelligent. And very ambitious too. She always wanted to travel the world, though Greece, Italy, you know.
Wow, I don't know why you were in this relationship for 20 years.
Well, because I moved here just last year and she met this photographer.
Did you drink anything?
No, just the wine and the soda.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure.
You're cheating at the game.
Which game?
Why do you guys use it?
Was what?
Come on. It's not about how big or strong the wand is. It's the magic it can do.
Wise words.
Want to use it?
Why not?
Let's use it.
Let's do it. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, fuck it.
No, fuck me.
Yeah, fuck you.
Okay, you're missing the point.
Sorry, I'm just confused.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Seriously?
Whew, what?
That was your best?
You didn't like him?
It was surprising.
I thought you were lagging.
I was.
So what?
Well, it's just, you know, people who haven't been married 20 years don't do missionary.
Why not? It's simple and efficient, like the missionary's mission.
Yeah, okay, it works, but, you know, the world's changed a lot in the last 20 years, right?
Right.
Well, So I want to bring you a new experience, but you've got to open your mind.
If you promises me that will be just my mind.
Okay. All right, so the safe word is vanilla.
For what?
Oh, you might want it.
Okay, but I think that is stop is a great safe word.
Yeah, but you know when you say stop, but like, you don't really want to stop.
No. Every time I say stop, I really want to stop.
Okay, but like, just for fun, the safe word's vanilla.
Okay. What are you gonna do with it? I'm just not prepared for this new normal.
You want some?
Please. So this is sex these days?
What do you mean this is sex?
If it was a movie, it would be the Fast and Furious.
You mean Mission Impossible?
Yeah, you're right. I heard about this 3-date rule to have sex. Is that right?
I mean, it used to be. Now with internet dating, it's so fast that you have sex on the first date because you don't know if there'll be a second.
Oh, nice. You know that in Brazil we don't date?
Really? So how do you do it?
We just hang out with people that we want to hook up. We don't have this emotional business of tell me about your professional life. I'll tell about my professional life and oh, we like each other. Let's live together because of it.
Interesting.
You just invite for a hangout. During the hangout, it can turn into a date. If you keep liking the person, it finishes as a hookup. And that's it.
Oh, so like what we're doing.
Sort of. Is that our friend?
Yeah, I should go call her.
Okay.
Crying like a cat in heat? Check.
Well, the top three episodes are Crying Like a Cat in Heat, Throwing Up from the 10th Window, and He Liked to Wear My Bra.
Challenge accepted.
Accepted.
I have a date tomorrow, so you better accomplish your stuff tonight. I don't want to beat you again.
You won't.
Take it easy, Annie. Tripping balls.
Yeah, yeah.
Rob? Rob? Rob?
Come on, everybody, baby. Do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Alexa, party lights.
Shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
How'd you know that? Shake your body, baby, do that
conga. No, I was just guessing.
Drinking game?
What should I do?
Do you have a deck of cards? So each card indicates something that we have to do, and whoever loses takes a drink of something. There's four kings. If you pull the last king, you have to drink the entire thing.
I don't know if I want to play this. I'm still a little drunk.
Come on, I only took the hearts, so we're not repeating cards. And you only have a 4 out of 16 chance of picking a king.
Just watch me pull every single one.
Well, rules are rules. Take a sip.
I did it first!
It should just be four fingers, but yeah, you won. This is the sip glass.
I did judo.
Both still have 2 episodes to go, Throwing Up and Underwear. Whoever completes them first will get the number 100 episode. Good luck.
Where'd you get that?
You should leave. I mess everything up.
Why would I leave?
I don't want to be embarrassed in front of you anymore.
You're not.
I'm not?
No. Arriba, abajo, al centro y adentro.
We'll drink again? Why? Sorry.
Do you want to play or are you going to call Vanilla?
You know what? I'm Brazilian, and I never give up.
All right. Two, you, choose someone to drink.
Be my guest.
Three, me. I choose you to drink.
I just wanna stop.
We're almost finished. Eight, mate. I choose someone to drink with me.
Video call some of your friends. It would be funny.
Fine. Hi. Playing Kings. Have a drink with me. Yeah. It's fun.
Bye. bottoms up.
Go, 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 go.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bottoms up.
I knew it.
Queen question. We ask each other a question, and whoever hesitates first loses.
Shoot me in the face.
Why are you doing this?
Because my niece wanted it. Because Mr. Phil encouraged me. Because I don't want to lose my job to a 14-year-old kid. And because I don't want to be alone anymore.
No,
not here. Not here. Not here. Don't throw them here. Here. Not in the dark. Not in the dark. Yeah. Go, 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 go.
Ah, eita, besta fera. Oh, this smell.
Fucking seriously?
Rob, buddy.
Just us?
I guess so, huh? Come on in. Oh boy, someone at a party, huh?
Yeah, whatever. Can I go to the bathroom?
Oh yeah, first one on the left. My bad.
We have a winner.
Oh, fuck. What's that?
Nothing. Just that stuff that Rob takes to make him feel more Brazilian.
Oh, okay. Not you though, right?
No, I'm American.
Oh, that explains the accent. Gamers aren't always good at life stuff.
Well, I've never had sex with any of them, so who am I to judge?
Well, mission accomplished.
How about we take you to the next level and spend the night?
I would, but I'm staying with my friend tonight, so I gotta go.
I'll just get you an Uber to your friend's place in the morning.
It's like 2 hours away, but yeah, I mean, if you want
to. 2 hours away, huh? You know what? I think I left my ID at the bar. We should go back and look for it.
Oh, okay.
I gotta take a quick dump, though.
Are you famous in Brazil?
A lot.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
How famous?
They did a song for me.
Your own song?
Yeah.
Sing it.
I bet you heard it.
Okay.
It's tall and thin, a young lovely dub, boy from South America walks by.
Hate to break it, that's not your song.
No?
No.
So they changed the lyrics.
Oh, okay. Someone here?
It shouldn't be.
Did you lock the door?
Did you lock the door? I just remember you pushing me in the face.
I don't remember. Be careful.
Thanks. You should have called.
I tried to text you, but you didn't answer me.
Oh, my.
It's probably in the bathroom.
Yeah.
Hey, I thought you were a redhead.
Red, brunette, pink, purple, blue. New color every hour.
Oh, how do you two know each other?
College.
Pub.
Huh.
Oh, yeah. I dropped that probably when
probably.
I... Oh, you wanna eat something? Well, you can drink something because we ate everything. The taco was great.
So good.
Oh, no, we gotta get back to the bar because she's gotta go back to the suburbs with her friends, so.
Oh, really? Do I? Great, okay. Guess I will.
I'll see you later tonight.
See you, bro. Is that your friend?
Yeah, she's going to the hospital.
Why?
She drank too much and they called an ambulance.
Oh. I never rode an ambulance. Should call one for us.
Maybe another night. I think we've had enough fun.
Yeah. Do you want to sleep here?
Sleep.
Oh, come on. In the name of Morgan Freeman's God. Please. Let's just watch a movie and sleep. We'll be the first couple to do it for the first time in this planet.
Me and you will be the first?
The first. We are collecting first tonight, right? Was the first punch in the face before a hello. Was the first let's just watch a movie and sleep. And the...
First date after 20 years.
First date after 20 years. We should celebrate it. Alexa, play some song to celebrate.
Enjoy.
What song is this?
I have no idea. This is Brenda's Alexa. I don't want to know what she's celebrating with this song. Sleep here tonight. It'll be good.
Isn't this going too fast?
Why?
Romantic.
It is.
I don't know.
I can call an Uber for you tomorrow.
Do you know how much an Uber is going to cost from here to my house?
It doesn't matter. If you don't leave, the date still goes on.
Yeah. It does.
So, let's just watch a movie.
What movie?
There's no time for a bench test. Heat 'em up. Do. Re.
He gone.
Oh, come on. What are you doing here? Is this a bed or what?
No, it's just my hand is unemployed and looking for a job.
Where did you hear that?
I made it up. Do you like it?
Oh, you made it up? Yourself?
Yeah, why?
I heard it on a podcast today.
What are you talking about?
Why you make me drink all night long?
Because it's fun. It relaxes us.
Am I your episode 100?
Of what? All right, where's that little bitch?
Okay, what is going on?
Wait.
What did you do to my uncle?
Nothing, Rob.
She's the one who catfished me.
Was that a catfish?
Yes, you are. You said you were 27. You're clearly 30. Okay, you filmed me and you showed me off to all your friends.
Oh, you filmed me too?
Yeah. Really?
Oh,
Oh, no, stop. Wait, just, why me?
He sent me a super like on Tinder.
Ooh, super like? That's always a mistake. Always.
Am I your episode 100?
I mean, technically you could be if I won the challenge.
What challenge?
Crying, throwing up, and wearing my underwear.
Did you do all of those?
Yep, I did. So you won.
No, I didn't. I didn't film you throwing up.
Sarah wearing her underwear? Nice.
Why did you do all this?
For the listeners. We have over 5 million per episode.
Oh, so you toying with people to please 5 million people that you don't know and that don't know you?
No, I mean, I do it because it's a joke.
No, it's not a joke. A joke is something that you say to the people to make them laugh. What you're doing is toying with people to make other people laugh.
Okay, so it's a prank.
Fuck.
Okay, that's enough. So can I hit her now?
Wait, you don't need to toy with people. Just ride the entertainment part and get the money.
J.K. Rowling never flew on a broom. Walt Disney never had a talking mouse. For the Shakespeare didn't kill himself to write Romeo and Juliet. Be smart.
Okay, I mean, I can talk to the group about it, but, you know, if you like the show, then that means you and 5 million other people around the world like how it's made.
Oh, yeah. Alexa, lights out.
Good night.
Oh, what a great punchline. And the cow went to the swamp. What does that mean?
Can you imagine how hard it is to get a cow out of a swamp?
Oh, I got it.
Yeah, it means that something went to a hard place to be saved.
Hmm. Good job. I haven't laughed this much since my husband got so drunk he threw up on a toilet lid on our honeymoon. Expensive hotel in New York, nice champagne, and a bathroom covered in vomit. Oh. It was fun, like reading this.
Thank you. Thank you.
This week I already have Victor Camejo on the cover with "Are Americans Ready for Their First Drag President?"
Ooh, I hope we all are.
Thank you, Robert. This is great. And it saved me from hiring the owner's daughter.
Oh, did she write something?
Yes, she did. 5 pages. It's time to talk about French fries.
What is the problem with the French fries?
Too much sodium. Those will kill you!
Ooh, what about stop the Himalayas to produce pink salt?
What about we stop the sea from producing salt?
What about to stop salt to be salty?
What about stopping people from dying of eating what they choose?
What about the food industry stop to produce healthy food that tastes like hell?
What about them making pizza that makes us lose weight?
What about we order pizza or fries?
What about you stop teasing me?
What about do we make the owner of the newspaper pay for it?
What a good thing to have you back.
It's awesome to be back.
Hello, planet Earth. My name is Alexa. I'm one of the members of Bad Dates, and we've decided I should tell the 100th story myself, straight from the horse's mouth. I'm happy to share my last story here, so welcome to episode number 100, The Final Date.
Love is like oxygen. You get so much, you get too high. Not enough and you're gonna die. Love gets you high.
Many of my stories have been told on this podcast, but my first one actually relates to this final one. It's episode 19, He Liked to Wear My Bra, when the guy put on my underwear to sing me Kiss from a Rose. Shakespeare didn't kill himself to write Romeo and Juliet, he told me. It's true, but I confess that I always tried making the date go wrong just to have a story for this podcast. Do I have any regrets? The truth is no, I really don't. But maybe it's time to make smarter choices that I will not regret in the future.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
It's okay.
So how's the newspaper?
Well, good. I'll be on the cover next week.
So I wanted to apologize for what happened last week.
It's okay. At least I got a good start out of it. And I opened my mind for new experiences.
Good. That's good.
I heard that you live in the podcast.
Yeah, I gave them your advice to write the stories instead, but they didn't go for it. And your niece gave me a touch of advice.
Sorry, Fred. What are you going to do now?
Well, with the podcast, the stories were kind of short, so I don't know. I thought I'd maybe turn it into a book of all my bad dates.
Who's interested in a book of bad dates?
I don't know. Someone, maybe. It's worth a shot.
And you planning to go to dates to make them bad again?
No. I think I'm done with Candid Camera.
Okay, good. Good. So, just for my information, is Charlie the guy from the Kiss from a Rose?
Want to see the video?
Love is life.
No way. I'd rather just... You speak a different Portuguese here.
Come on, what's the big deal to just download an app to see what's out there?
No, don't even start this car right now.
Okay, how old are you?
Oh, Marcy.
What happened?
Out of my league? Do I have a league? again.
Look, if you say something stupid, just delete the account.
What if I just...
If you say something stupid, just delete the account.
Sorry.
If you say something stupid, just delete the account. And I mean, you know, hey, look.
No.
Nah.
Two. Okay.
Cut. It's a big deal. Jeez.
Oh, was it cut? Yeah.
Sorry.
All right, here's it. What were you doing there?
Right after
we
said no.
Sorry.
Just let me know when you need me because I need to be
inside the house.
Dave cooked for me on our first official date.
Didn't you guys just fuck in the car?
No, that was after. First.
Sorry. I didn't mean to say fuck.
What? Why? 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 What has happened here? What? What the fuck? Why do I want to know that? Why do I want to do? Don't hire foreigners for your movies. Oh, that's my movie.
Mike.
Yeah. When?
She'll be here at 9.
Why? I will delete the app. Sorry, I say your line.
I did that.
Don't put. Okay, sorry.
First of all, I don't even like trucks. I will say trucks. Sorry.
Let's go. I don't want to miss happy hour.
Okay, deal. First 3 rounds on me. Yes. The food's on the stove. Don't forget to turn off the stove.
Got it.
Cut. Tasty.
Alexa, which song you want to listen to?
That was Layla Acoustic from Complete Clapton by Eric Clapton.
Well, I'll be in the cover. On the cover, right?
Is one of some?
One of some is kind of like a QTSN thing, but it should be.
One some is better, right? Alexa,
party lights?
I'm not sure.
No wine, just chimichanga and ice cream. Want some?
It's so much showing to the camera, all right? I'll do it again. Wayne's World. What?
Shot Larry, take one, Mark.
Shot Mo, take one, Mark.
And Fernanda was at my class. At or on? At.
In?
In my class?
Oh, yeah.
English is hard, right?
It is.
Take one, Mark. First shot, John Mossman, take five, Mark.
We met at the BDSM party.
No, you didn't.
You're fucking right. Fuck, right?
Oh, no, you didn't.
You're right. Fuck, she's got me. Every shot.
Scene 24, shot Jeff Griggs, take three, Mark. Four shot Julie, take two, Mark. Shot Jacare, take one, Mark.
I love her.
Scene 24, shot John Hancock, take four, Mark.
Tortilla is so big.
I don't know which group she belongs to.
Cut.
Yeah.
Scene 26, shot efficient, take one, Mark.
What are you gonna do with it?
Vince.
Oh, fuck, again.
Sorry.
What are you gonna do with it? Good.
I should go call her.
Good.
Oh, I don't know about furious. Oh, not so furious.
She offended me.
I'm just speaking the truth.
Shot Brazil, take one, Mark.
I'm not sure about that.
Almost not. No, I'm just missing us. Sorry.
Porque você é fraco.
Yeah, sorry, I'm wrong.
Sorry, I don't know that.
You hurt yourself?
No. Okay. Nine rhyme. You try to say, ugh.
You can try to rhyme.
But what if I rhyme?
Try it. Fail.
I don't know, I wasn't set. Seven heaven. Last. Seven heaven. The last one to point to the sketch.
Don't rush. You're explaining to me.
Okay.
Yes, that. Sorry. Yes, all right, let's start. Sorry. Yes, all right. Okay. Yes, all right, let's start. Playing with the words at this night. You. Yes, all right, let's start. Okay. Let's, right, like that. Fuck. I did it first.
Scene 35, shot A, pick up take three, Mark.
Cut.
Here. Front of the camera. Again, just the reset. Fuck, man. Dang!
Cut. Scene 46, shot Fernandez, take one, Mark.
That's me. Oh, you wanna drink something? Sorry, I'll repeat that.
Okay, cut.
Where did you hear that?
I made it up.
you guys are all in the reflection.
A great audience, like,
Hi, Mom.
Behind the movie?
Well, look, you record, you film. I'm just going to start from this line.
Okay.
Well, look, you. I don't know why I'm having. Wow. So difficulty with the word filmed.
I know, it's hard. Right?
All right.
So can I? Nope.
Again.
Alexa, lights out.
No, I jumped all your lines, right?
Yes. It's like maybe we're just cutting to the next part.
No, sorry.
That's the scene 50, and this is Renee.
All right.
Okay, it's an action.
Those will kill you!
Holding for the plane.
Alexa, play some song to celebrate.
Here's a station you might like. Classic rock, Clean, on Amazon Music.
What song is this?
Well, it's Brenda's Alexa. I don't want to know what she celebrates with this song.
What? Rob?